Speaking to the New Vision, Charles Mwembeze, the association chairman, noted that 5 years later, they are still scared of what happened in Kenya and are now taking all precautions to remain safe should a similar thing happen. He noted that they want their members to explore alternative routes for their own safety, though Mombasa through Malaba to Busia and Uganda is the shortest route. He added that although 7 years ago the southern corridor through Dar es Salaam to Mutukula was unsafe and dusty, this has now changed with maximum security and reduction of checkpoints and way bridges. So, I asked him about the extra costs. Mwembeza said every alternative route comes with a cost but could be safer. For instance, currently a 40-foot container from Mombasa through Busia costs between US$3,500 to $4,000, while a 20-foot costs between US$2,500 to $3,000. If one uses the southern route, they will pay an extra $700 to $1,000, but for a business person, safety of the goods is more precious than the costs incurred. The association is also looking to utilize the local marine cargo insurance, which came into effect at the start of this financial year. The preparation of the association comes days after the government of Uganda announced that it was getting set to avoid being caught off guard, as was the case in 2017. Solomon Mita, the Energy Ministry spokesperson, recently, while appearing on one of the local stations, said that government could have as many as three backups if the Northern Corridor route is affected by any post-election violence. So what would happen to Uganda in a worst-case scenario after the Kenyan elections? Well, Dr. Fred Mwomza, a seasoned economist, says the major impact would be fuel prices shooting higher, though it would not last longer. He said these elections are happening at a time when these two countries need one another. Uganda would suffer, but Kenyans too need food from Uganda, so they would not allow their citizens to starve.